Alright, have another submission in Dusk's Discord here. Ooh, nice. Looks like Mean has beaten it here. I mean, this is generally a really good combo. Mainly, it's like you don't really need any particular version of Primordium to be good here. Literally, all three are good because Root Seeds, even if you like start Stalwart, it's okay with Root Seeds. And then you can pivot. You can start Stalwart and like pivot into something. But probably, like if you see aggressive, you should just take aggressive. Looks like it did take Eable down though. Justin Brar is the submitter. Let's see what we can do. I mean, I will say this about this. The three clans in the game, in my opinion, that really can run into problems with cursedness are Awoken, Umbra, and Stygian, and to a lesser extent, Melting Remnant. But, you know, those three to four, when you have them combined, even when it's like a strong combo like this one, the possibility of cursedness is always there, because the problem is these clans don't really have scaling past either like unit, like passives, or just common spells. So you kind of get screwed into a nightmare scenario. Melting has a lot more ways to hit though in the late game, and I think Umbra kind of does, but it's kind of like also Umbra at the same time has by far the worst uncommon draft pool in the game, so it's like you basically hit Voidbinding or bust. In this combo though, Voidbinding is an absolute carry because the Awoken backliners. So we got Awoken at the steel, that's great. Awoken at a steel again is fine if we miss here. Does suck to give up a Vortex and Hellvent though, if we have to do that. So the starters, yeah, they're alright. I'm honestly, with the Prismal Dust and a Patient, I would pick Superfood if it's available. Maybe even over aggressive. I think I could be fine doing that. Yeah, and between Stalwart and Superfood, I would take Superfood all day there. Jack Strips. I mean, one thing I will say is early game isn't necessarily that strong here, at least Ring 1. As far as, but I mean, with a two Glimmers and Plinks, I don't know, probably Jack Strips isn't really that useful, in all honesty. Just take a Pyrestone housing. I mean, I've already seen that, like, potentially we would hit two steals. I don't know. That steal is pretty good. I mean, there's not that many great steals, though, in all honesty. Like, this is technically not a good steal if we already have our unit here. And if we don't have our unit here, then this steal doesn't really count, does it? It's like, this is essentially the first steal in the context of that. So really, it's just one steal. So do I just take Jack Strips anyway? I doubt I actually need to make morsels. Kind of think I'm just going to take Jack Strips, because I actually highly doubt that this Pyrestone housing can pop off. But Jack Strips at the same time, I don't know. With the two Glimmers, the Plinks, let's just take this housing. It's probably just has more value to the run. Fungus could be okay. I mean, we already have damage shield, though. It's pretty hard to not have damage shield, or to have a need for regen when you have damage shield. Firebox has some upside. Penumbra right now, I guess we have the Cannibalize. I highly doubt we actually make use of Cannibalize. Cannibalize is just not a good card, in my opinion. Okay, unit draft happens as long as we think that we're not going to die here. I think we're not going to die here. This will definitely cost us some pyre health though, because there's no fucking way we're taking out the thing here. Oh my god. That's a pretty high roll. We're definitely not losing to the boss, I can tell you that much. Probably no point in putting the stewards down. I was hoping to get some sort of damage morsel, and it literally gave me nothing. Like, about as bad as it could have been. Yeah, whatever. Whatever. Yeah, we don't need that, clearly. I guess I should have just eaten up the lifesteals, but whatever. Is there any way I can fucking kill this guy? No? No, I guess we just take that damage then. Jesus. That would probably kill half the game, that much damage shield. Alright. It's highly unlikely I would ever go with an Umbra banner unit with two Oaken banners here and this unit draft coming up here. So, do I ever take a making of a morsel? I mean, there's still, like, Shroud Spike potential there, and also is just maybe some extra scaling. You never know. Like I said, this is a combo where if I don't hit on Ember Drain, and I don't hit on Razor Sharp Edge, my only scaling is Root Seeds. Would it be nice to just have a making of a morsel there? Then there's Space Prism, which could work. I mean, it's not out of the question we have to take, like, a large stone and maybe something else that adds pip. I don't know. I doubt it, though. I highly doubt it. I could see skiffing here, honestly. It's either skiff or making of a morsel. I think I would take a making of a morsel. Oh, well, there's the Razor Sharp Edge. But we're not too sad. We should have a clear line to victory here. Shattered Shell for sure. Still want to try for probably multi-strike here. I think that makes sense. Yeah. Or quick. Multi or quick is going to be equally as good here. I would take a Shitstone. I'm probably not feeding this guy morsels now that I have a Razor Sharp Edge. Alright, that's a quick. We'll add it. I have a Pirate Stone housing as well. How greedy can I be here? Definitely not that. Gnarled Root? I would probably take a Sharpen if that's the case. I mean, think about the stacking potential there. The funny thing is, it's still not as good as a Razor Sharp Edge, like, right? Because it's a 2 cost. I'm getting 8, and I still only stack 8, but if they hit me, then it's fine. I might actually just take the Refracting Lenses, but I don't have any. I guess I do have the Consumables. Because I could definitely leak here. I'm going to be slow at scaling, all things considered, without a multi-strike. We hope for an Animus of Will infusion, I think. I don't think I'm going to settle for a Battlestone here. I have one steel I'm for sure hitting at some point. It's probably worth not hitting that Hellvent, by the way, if I don't have a good infusion here, because just another, even like a Shitstone, as I said, is going to be good. We'll see. I Now this is definitely a fight where the jack strips probably would have been fine. So I still have two glimmers. I still have all these plinks. I have these prismal dusts. 75 gold. I don't necessarily need gold coming up. I may still go to this Merchant of Magic though, at which point I would. This is definitely risky. This is where like adding the battle stone would give me a little more buffer, but I don't know, I get 10 health a turn. And I should at least be able to plink some of this. 30 shards though, the plinks might not hit that much. This is potentially not worth it, but I think it's fine. Alright, that's a good glimmer. And we even get some health here too, which is nice. Put you here for, well, I guess you're just gonna die here. Alright, nice, we get a slay. That's good, let's do this. We don't actually want to go back into it, I don't think. Okay. That breaks both damage shields. I think that's fine. I'm fine actually redrawing those as well. Wow, that's pretty good plink. Interesting cannibalizes. I mean, I can't really complain about that one. 69, I definitely can't complain about it. Alright. Mortal trade, so we know we're not getting perils. We know we're not getting mind collapse. Engraft is still on the menu. Zero costing out the deck is still kinda on the menu, but it would be bad for these prismal dusts. Although if I intrinsic them, it wouldn't. Here's the thing, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 1 out of 3 chances into intrinsic. If I get an intrinsic, there's no way in hell I need a mortal trade. No way in fuck do I need that. I could see a skip here. The space prism, I don't know. Even if I get a single shitstone, I doubt I would add another pip to this guy. We just skip here. I mean, is Sharpen still okay? Like, is it? Kinda don't think so. Just skip. Now, this is by far the worst artifact combo clan. Even the Umbra ones that you sometimes want to see are pretty much not happening here. As far as essences, I doubt there's an Umbra essence we want that much. Like, Morsel Makers even, it's not that good. It's okay. I've really scaled back how much I like the Morsel Maker infusion. I think it's a very lackluster one. It's mildly worth the 25 shards, let's put it that way. I think when you start thinking in terms of like, is it worth the shards, it becomes more apparent which essences are really worth it or not. I'm probably just going to go left here, get some cost reductions. I still would like to open up, like let's say I do find a void binding or a furnace tap. I would like to open up the possibility for like zero costing out a deck. Ooh, holdover. Okay. That's not really going to be that good for me. I don't really, I mean, if I never find a multi-strike, for example, I'll really want to cash in on the plus three slay, right? Even with, like, Razor Sharp Edge and stuff. I think a Razor Sharp Edge is worth holding over, probably. I don't have to always use it on Primordium, necessarily. I don't think I'll reroll here, because if I don't hit here, I don't think I'm going to Hellvent. I don't really need to remove that much either, since I've already skipped a lot of cards. Like, I kind of want to just try to fill up my Pyrestone housing here. And because these Glimmers aren't really that useful to me, just do that. Oh, I should have done this first. Fuck. Too bad I don't have a Shroud Mitosis. I don't know. I don't really have anything that great here. I could make... I think I'm just gonna purge. Purge a Plink. Could purge the Cannibalize, though, honestly. Is that probably worse? And might as well do it while I have... Nah, let's just do a Plink. Just do a Plink. That's easy enough. Not a great opener. That's all right, though. Get one of the damage shield, right? Get four stacks, that's good. Not necessarily out of the weeds yet, though. We do kind of need to get... Ooh, Shroud Spike. It's probably worth adding. There's a lot of potential power there with the making of a morsel. The others are pretty just not working here. And, you know, similar to what I said about the Morsel Maker, I don't think the Shattered Shells infusion is worth 25 shards. I can spend shards on better shit. I would almost argue, like, a Steward and a Steward infusion is more worth it there, just simply as a removal. This is really just not a good infusion. So, I don't think we're Hellventing. I mean, what would I Hellvent? I guess, at this point, Shroud Spike is an okay Hellvent. But it's not great because of the Making of Morsel. Like, if... I would rather have the Making of Morsel on a holdover at that point. We have some money to add to our low total here. We really hope to hit Animus of Will, though. That's about the only unit we can hit here that's useful to us. I may just also just put a Steward in... I could put Steward into Shell if I'm going to do that. Because there's no pickups at the Uncommon or Rare Draft tier for units that have essences that I care to put on a Shattered Shell. Maybe a Wildwood, like, plus one draw thing is, like, okay. I think I'd rather just have the stats. It's most likely draw. I'm trying to think if there's any reason not to go draw. Nah, there's no reason. You could maybe argue Ember, but I wouldn't. We now have incentive not to take the Shitstone, by the way, because I kind of benefit quite a lot from that Shroud Spike, potentially. I wouldn't do the Spell Chain. I think you need Shade Splitters to make Spell Chain Shroud Spike be consistent. If you're relying, because think about it, there's only two things in this game that generate rubber morsels. It's Shade Splitters and Plinks. But Plinks are a pretty hard thing to consistently get off, especially come Lax Divinity when you got basically six targets on the board and they have damage shield anyway. So, or a spell shield, and I could add Pierce to one, but what I do wish I had right now is a Lightstone casing, because I would totally spell chain my Razor Sharp Edge. I suppose what I could do, I don't know. These are absolutely just not what I'm looking to find. Like, I want a minus two. I would put that on the Shroud Spike. I would want an intrinsic. I would probably, at this point, since I'm struggling to come up with shard, especially if this is not a Animus of Will, like, I'm just struggling with things to put shards into right now. Alright, no whammy. That's a whammy. Alright, I guess we're not putting anything to the Shattered Shell unless it's a Steward. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not gonna put a Shattered Shell into it. It's just too fucking weak. And I think I'll do 25 health. I think I'm just looking for a multi-strike at this point. I don't think I can justify a Shitstone. I really do need, damn. Well, we got one more steel we'll hit. We'll wait for multi-strike there, hopefully. Yeah, I don't know. It's a little cursed. I think we'd want to hold out for Stalwart. If I can get a stack of Stalwart, that'll help me quite a lot. I will also say, you know, adding here that if I get stuck with Superfood 3, that's not going to be so fun. Wow, spikes twice in a row. I thought that was not possible. Apparently it is. I mean, this, if I can handle the other spikes, I should be able to handle the spikes. Really should be no difference here. Not that the reward is that good. It's going to be tough without finding another holdover or permafrost to reliably make the Shroud Spike work. But I don't know, I probably won't hit this helmet. Kind of sucks that we passed up two helmets. I mean, this was a complete whiff over here. We didn't get a good Awoken Banner. And I didn't get anything good at the steel other than 25 health, so, like, you could argue we're chasing multi-strike here, and it was incorrect, but my counter-argument is that we didn't really have a great hell vent, and I didn't really need to make any removals. But it's entirely possible we were meant to go left there, but I definitely don't think I'm going left here, because I still don't think I have a good... If I didn't have a good helmet then, I don't have it now, unless I hit some crazy good uncommon here. Most likely we will just go to here, maybe hit something good here. The Vortex is still going to be nice, but I really do want, like, a holdover or a permafrost at this Merchant of Magic. It's crazy that, like, just a gold, or just a 25 health and a reroll basically nullified a Forgotten Boons. That's also why I don't really value boons that much. I'll take the money here, in favor of 3 attack. And we'll want attack versus damage shield, even though there is, you know, a lot of spikes and stuff. As you can see here, this guy is going to hit us for a little bit. I'm going to wait to redraw that, I think. And never mind. Let's just... Oh man, are we gonna fucking die here? I have like no fucking... Well, I might as well wait on it to replenish health. We gotta do all of this then. It's fucking wild. On 30 shards, I still have to fucking deal with this motherfucker right here. The fuck? We'll get an okay shroom spike off. I don't think we'll die, but god, this sucks. Jesus, look how much fucking damage that one guy did, because we have such bad RNG there. Oh my god. Hopefully that's the fucking last of it. If I were to do this, he would go to 110. Thus, yeah. Fuck me, pretty much. This guy, of course, has to have one spikes. You want to draw as much as possible. Maybe I should have let that die. Maybe I don't want to let these guys hit me, huh? Okay, we barely win there. Thank God for Plink. Apparently Plink best card in the fucking game. Well, that went about a million times worse than I thought it would. This'll definitely help. In a way, that was almost worth it. And yeah, this is pretty much... This is... you know, fucking Umbra uncommons in a nutshell. If you think the uncommon, or if you think the Umbra banners are bad, wait till you get a load of their uncommon pool. Oh god. Could maybe justify Wildwood Custodian as an infusion. Will cost me 25 shards right now, which I don't know if I can spare. I might argue. Okay, if I Hellvent something, what the fuck's it gonna be? The Razor Sharp Edge, maybe? I don't know. Kind of fucked right now. I'm gonna skip. I think there's just too much value over here. It's playing to lose, I think, over there. There's the Permafrost. Probably Permafrost the Shroud Spike then. God damn it. It's literally giving you the worst fucking shit I can possibly get here. Would it kill you to give me a fucking intrinsic? Alright, let's see what's here. Blood for blood, but... Yeah, blood for blood. God, I hope I don't just... We really hope for, like, sycophants, I think. Well, no, not really. Not really sycophants. We don't want sycophants. And I'm inclined not to spend any shards here. We just gotta... Now we have to make sure we can get to fucking... 100 by the end, because there's just nothing good to spend shards on. Fucking weak, dude. Yeah, and this is all weak as fuck. Even with the permafrost, like I said, I can't rely on these plinks, but permafrosting this should help. Get that down, that intrinsically also upgrades the other thing. What if we need to replay this? At the cost of, you know, however much. I'll tell you what, if I can get a holdover on the the making of Immortal. Is that likely? Not necessarily. And I probably want to save some gold coming up, even though I got a Boons and a Divine Boons, and I probably need to get the Divine Boons. We'll just hold out. These being cheaper would be good. Surge Stone, another Glimmer, I guess? I don't know. Am I good into Stealth Boss? If I hit the Prismal Dust at the right time. Yeah, let's get rid of the Planks anyway. I know they just saved my ass. Cannibalize is probably fine to keep while we still have all of our stewards. Yeah, I'm not gonna spend shards. Oh boy. Problem is, like, this probably would kill me. Fuck me. I really want that gold, though. Yeah, I don't think we can do that. These trials have just been motherfucking brutal. Well, that's a pretty shit draw. Is what it is, I guess. Because I could have, Of course, on the Ember Drain turn is the turn I gotta draw that shit. Well, do we do it now? Kinda need as much damage shield as possible to beat fucking multi-strike boss. I think we need to do this. Just hopefully my pyre can live. Still get a slay. Yeah, I think we gotta try to beat the boss. Mitigating some of the damage with the Blood for Blood. We'll go all in here. Don't think we'll find a better Shroud Spike. So funny, like, this fight, they decided not to shard up Eclipse Guardian, so as you can see, I don't lose 110 fucking health. I actually gain health on this fight. Should try to play that thing if I can. I wonder, should I put this down? If he eats the hit, that's fine, right? Right, we get our health. We're getting through it. It's definitely been rough. This, like I said, this is... And we even found Razor Sharp Edge and Holdover, and it's still pretty rough, right? Like, it sucks to hit a unit draft and two Awoken Banners and not get an Animus of Will, or even a Husk Hermit. I don't know, like, Husk Hermit wouldn't help with the problems we're running into, but in general the Husk Hermit would be fine. I guess generally preferred, in my opinion, than the Shattered Shell. And I don't know, Gem Trove maybe. It would definitely help the Shroud Spike's consistency. But I'm hitting a steel, so it's currently unplayable, so I'm not gonna take it. In Graft, probably not good enough, honestly. I would need Ember Drain in hand to justify taking that. Take a Wildwood Custodian, unless I think Steward Infusion is just fine. Steward Infusion, if I have to make it, is probably just fine. I don't even... It's weird. You'd think this would be a good essence. It really just kind of isn't. But I might take it here, and I could justify an Ember upgrade. I think an Ember upgrade would help this deck. I don't know. I don't know if I really need extra starting stats, though. Yeah, I probably don't need our extra starting stats. Just having an extra draw might be nice. I guess I'll take that. I can't fuse it yet, but it is what it is. Yeah, multi-strike. Alright. Wasn't cursed enough to give us three steals without a multi-strike. Still say this is the right call because it has the vortex attached. Do I take this? I probably should. Oddly enough, I still probably should keep Cannibalize. I'm sorry, Planks. You really didn't deserve to get removed like this, but my hand is kind of forced here. You did good this run. You actually saved me from certain death, but it's just business. These are the type of runs where Faulty Loader just really fucking shines. Alright, we're gonna win. I'm almost certainly not gonna need this. So why don't we just play it? If anything, I'll need it for the, you know, if I leak, having the extra health might be nice. I think I'll be good on the damage shield front. Can't really throw these out as well. Let's just do this. And yeah, I doubt I end up needing that. Let's do that. Incant, you say? Incant, you say? I say fuck you. That's what I say. Alright, how are we gonna do this? Let's go. Do I care about these root seeds? Well, we're just gonna leak a little bit. Fuck it. Who fucking cares? Let's get these out of here. And yeah, I'll just draw more cards. That guy hit me twice, what a bitch. Grr. Ah, fuck. You need to get down there. I'm not killing him anyway, might as well get one in there. Technically break even on that guy. Bye-bye, 69. No better time than the present to do that. Oh, we're killing that, so that's nice. Should pretty much have this on lockdown here. Here, let's take you out. I think with 29 shield, I'm gonna care too much about, you know, a health morsel. Make sure you don't hit Cannibalize. Adaptive mutation. Funny thing about that is, like, it might be better than the plus one draw, because it I don't know. I'm not going to take a pip upgrade here, but I would take maybe an ember upgrade, which intrinsically kind of means I'm probably going to be drawing 10 a lot of the time anyway, so like an extra draw on my unit doesn't matter that much. The superfood, I mean, this represents, say I get a stalwart stack, that's 5, it's already a 5 initial damage, and then 2, but the 2 will resolve on the subsequent one, so it'd be like 4 times, be 2 times, so it'd be 5 and 5, so 10 spikes just to the unit itself, but then superfood brings back in, 8 spikes, so it's like 18 spikes. Yeah, it's not that. It's not probably not worth it. Adaptive mutation could. Yeah, it's probably not going to do anything. If I had a void binding. Or a perils, but I don't. Speculatively, it's not going to be that good of an add. If I had a husk hermit, maybe. Then it's just a nice little boost to damage. I mean, I do have the initial health here, but. Most of the time, this is just not going to be good enough. Just seems like another skip. A lot of bad fucking cards in this. It is like kind of cursed. I mean, thing I will say is like at least we found Shattered Shell. At least we found Multi-Strike. There's a Shroud Spike. There's a Holdover Razor Sharp Edge. Those are the powerful parts of this. And then, yeah, there's Superfood Damage Shield, which is powerful. With the every now and then improved firebox. But, otherwise, it's, I don't know. It's definitely kind of cursed, otherwise. It might be nice to hit that version of Magic, honestly. Like, I feel like at this point, let's say I found a, like, the nuts would be a holdover into a consumer move, but. Because, like, I don't know. I don't like Ring 7 trinkets. I like a free trinket. I like a cavern, but. I don't know. Like. What's the worst case scenario? I get permafrost and double stack? You know, double stack still isn't horrible on a Prismal Dust. I hope we can finally get either a minus 2 or a fucking intrinsic. Holdover's the best. Consumer move, I would probably take it blind into Shroud Spike here. I think I'm able to hit it enough. Cannibalize. But yeah, double stack, eh. And shit frost, eh. But if I can get holdover or consume remove, ideally holdover. I don't know. It seems like I'm chasing holdover, honestly. Like, I don't even like the consume remove here because. That really predicates on hopefully getting a whatever later. I could just hit on like an X cost artifact here or something. But let's just go this way. There's way more value on the left here. Okay, we got an intrinsic. Let's do our due diligence and go through the motions over here before we lock it in. Pretty bad stuff there. Well, definitely the luggage, probably. Gauge is pretty good in Umbra, typically, but at this point, no. We have literally one card draft left, and I have built not at all into it. Necta really doesn't benefit from gauge, though it's also not terrible with it, honestly. This is between a 0 and a 2 cost. I have some cost reductions here and there. The X costs won't be affected. I have an Ember upgrade, but yeah, it's just lost luggage. There's no way it's not. I don't see anything here working other than maybe Boon. Maybe with a multi-strike I need to be a little more confident. Let's see what champ path we're getting, actually. Can I get a stalwart? No? Fuck. Well, definitely no point in going more into superfood. We'll just start with a little extra damage, and that sucks, so... That definitely sucks. I think we're also... We're most certainly intrinsicking a Prismal Dust, so... Rage, definitely. And buff, definitely. Nothing there. That's a good card. Now it's a razor sharp edge. It also gives me rage. Just sucks up. I don't know. It really sucks that we only have three stacks of the Primordium. I wish that, like, third rank superfood gave you, like, at least one extra stack. Kind of sucks to not get stalwart, but whatever. Well, the thing is, like, I can have some pretty bad scaling still. I probably should hell vent the razor sharp edge. I think I can do better than a boon, though. Never mind, fuck. Well, like I said, the stuff between this is horrible. Absolute ass, but at least still let's find like a root split mask or something. Alright, definitely intrinsicking that. I mean, fuck, I've got a lot of, I need to make sure I can get 25 shards between here and there. Don't think a 30 is what I'm looking for, though. If need be, I should be able to get... You know, I'll leave the stewards around for infusion, I guess, if I need them. I could also just remove two right now, though, because I'm not going to need the others. I could just... I know I have the cannibalize right now. But, I think I'll definitely just get rid of two of these right now. You never know. 20 card deck. I mean, I draw the whole deck in two turns. But, can never be too sure, can ya? This is exactly why I can't be too sure. Because bullshit like the Pentatigasus. At least we got the faulty loader counter, though. Definitely think I can do the 20 armor, hopefully. It's honestly not that much of a given. I mean, we're already bottom, you know, we're already losing a 2 50-50s on not getting the razor sharp edge of the old magic. Not really, I guess it's like 8 cards I'm drawing. 7, I guess. Still though, like, you hope to draw at least one of them here. Cycle back in. There's too much good shit to do here right now. Too much good shit. I definitely want that collector. 69 by 2. Draw as much as possible. We want to get to the Morsel Miner again. So I'm doing 132 by 2. This guy's 250 health. I do kill that then. So we can just do this. I'm probably not gonna find a better turn to do this. Cause I'm always gonna have two things that I gotta take care of. But well, yeah, I'd like to play this, actually. So I guess there's definitely better turns then. Can you not draw together, please? Okay, they finally didn't draw together, and I get to draw them without the stuff, so that's good. Nice. There we go. That's a play right there. See you later. That's a void binding. Significantly worse because we only have three stacks on our Primordium, but we draw it pretty early. I could... Let me think if this is worth adding. I would say in the context that I already have a million damage shield. I do kind of want Ember in this deck because of this. But that's just a one-time play. I could zero-cost old magic. I hate to say it, but past a certain point, this deck just needs to play Razor Sharp Edge, right? I don't really need this if I'm going to get a Void Binding. The Void Binding, you know, I could double stack it. It opens up double stack. Right now I don't have a good double stack. It also kind of takes precedence on Holdover. Because if I see a Holdover, even locking it in right now and the making of a morsel doesn't make that much sense. I think we take the Void Binding. And Snare's definitely worth it. Mini boss right now is not really taken care of, so thank God we found that. I'd be lying if I didn't say it's the first time that mini boss crossed my mind. I'm ashamed to admit it, but it's the truth. Now, speaking of mini bosses, I'll probably take that as well. That's a holdover. Well, zero cost holdover void binding is probably happening. 50% of the time it's annoying because you'll get Scourge mini boss, but whatever. I've got a lot of health built up. I don't really see myself losing any health in the Seraph the Patient fight. It's a little annoying. It gave us 30 in Spell Chain every time. We never got minus 2. This one's an annoying one to put the Purge Stone on. Let me think about this. If I'm going to hold over Void Binding, it really doesn't hurt this deck that much. I can only zero cost one additional card, so we have this already zero costed. This most likely just becomes kind of useless, but it kind of already is anyway, because we didn't hit. It's not useless, but it's not really... It's the lowest roll, essentially, for what you can think about, but... Yeah, I'm thinking zero cost Void Binding, zero cost the old magic, hold over the Void Binding. But probably... I don't know. I mean, I'm quick. I'm already gonna have a million damage shield. Why don't I just hold over the old magic? I get more damage out of it than Void Binding. You know, I get 18. This gets me 12. Yeah, I get the damage shield, but who cares? I actually regret the Void Binding now. I didn't think that went through too much, but you know what? It's fine. You don't want to get too into the sunken cost fallacies. I think I'm going to check the trinkets out a little more here, though. Like, definitely not those. Let's take this and see what else we got. Okay. Hell's Banners, maybe, but at that amount of gold, and I definitely have this holdover that's going to be good, but... Yeah, let's just put it here. So I could reroll. I have removals I could do. Most likely just want to do removal, huh? Do 120 into 150. That's not really gonna work. So why don't we just reroll and see what we got? Alright, is that worth it? I think it is. I think that I can give up a little bit of, and you know, the first time I play at speed for just continued benefit. Otherwise I'm never eating the making of a morsel past the first eat. So I think that works. Can't even make a removal now, but that's fine. I think Voidbinding is still fine to have in the deck. Against Patient, it might play. I don't know. We'll see. Might as well do this. Okay. You know, seeing these, I'm probably just going to do this. And I could purge here if I want. I'm still at 100, 110. I think this is fine to do. I highly doubt I'm going to make use of Cannibalize anymore. It'll be hard to actually purge it out, but I think I can do it. And I'm just going to Hellvent this, I guess. Is that making sense? I mean, I got them in holdover already, so I get them every turn, but like, just makes it so this basically always plays. Eh, it's kind of weird, isn't it? It's kind of a weird duplicate. Maybe this is still the best duplicate. This is probably still the best duplicate. Yeah, let's just do that. Alright, I'm feeling okay. We added a ton of power between ring 7 and on. That old magic actually ended up being pretty legit. Lost Luggage is decent, Root Slip Mass is great. Patient doesn't even start top, which is even more awesome. I could Void Binding here. Zero. This would not be able to get played at the, unless it's drawn with that, which will happen often enough. In all honesty, it will happen often enough. I don't need to play Shroud Spike this fight. I'm open to this. That's quite a lot of extra damage if I'm able to just do it from the start like this. I may as well play this out. Get it out of the deck. Eat that for nothing, essentially. It's fine. To consume, so it was pointless for me to play that. Actually, somehow back to a point where I can play cards. I don't think I'll play the Void Binding here. I could just wait and actually get an okay Shroud Spike off. I could technically get a better Shroud Spike off, but... eh. Alright, patient, easy as usual. Still gonna go top. We're probably not, just kinda like I said, we're not gonna probably play Void Binding in this fight. Let's get that out of there. Starting with this is awesome. Let's draw one more at the cost of a damage shield. And, you know, I will lose a little bit of this, but I don't care. Let's just not redraw the other Prismal Dust. Let's go ahead and get an okay spike off here. We can actually heal ourselves here, that's fine. I'll have enough damage shield. This is annoying, I guess. Maybe I should have thought about glimmering that. It is what it is, though. I think I'd still rather get a good Shroud Spike off. If I lose all of my damage shield, I'll lose all my damage shield. It's not that big of a deal, in all honesty. Like, I'm doing quite a lot of damage. I could do this to save a little bit of damage shield, actually, and it's probably an okay play to do. I could also do that. I think I will. If I can keep redrawing it, I'd rather just keep her down there. I did redraw it again. Well, do that. It's actually fine that this comes in the front, but I can mitigate as many of these spikes as possible. Saving as much damage shield as possible. Right? Damn, they rolled spikes again like a bunch of assholes. I would be sure to try to kill them before I get to that, maybe. Tell you what, you can stay down there. You bitch. And now that you're dead, I'll give myself a void binding. I've earned it. Alright, pretty good. I think this is a good illustration of why the combo is good, right? And why superfood is generally just... This is like a mid-roll superfood run, I would say, in this combo. I can usually find more out of my superfood, but what we got here is mainly just damage shield and every now and then some rage. That's really all we got out of superfood. But it's still, like, good enough. But, yeah, this just shows, I think, just the power of a sweeper. The power of Shroud Spike was alright. I don't think it shows out the power of it, but definitely the power of Razor Sharp Edge and Old Magic for what that's worth. But yeah, just a pretty clean victory. There's definitely some tough ring 4 and 5, which is funny because, like, usually if I have a tough ring 4 and 5, it's not because I'm at 30 shards, right? Though I will say it was pretty abysmal luck at 30 shards to still get that fucker. You know, 78 damage because of that. This would have been like a 10 to 15 damage floor otherwise. Pretty fucked. But you know, it is what it is. We get through it. We weathered the storm of those weird low rolls. The run would have definitely been tougher without a multi-strike. But the nice thing is, aside from arguably one, you know, the ring 4, it's not like we didn't add value to our deck on the steals that we found. I still maintain, I think, that given our deck just didn't really have any good hell vents and wasn't in dire need of removals, that like even just health at that point, we didn't even have health on our shell. Even just some health was nice, but like, you know, a chance at Animus of Will, it's not that low of a chance to get Animus of Will when you factor in that there's at that point the chance of a rare is pretty low. It's just one pick. You know, you factor in the chance of a rare throughout the whole run with like four banners is like 20%. So I don't know, with one it's like down to like 5 or 10%. So you're mostly looking at uncommons. There's six of them, so you basically have a 1/3 chance to find Animus of Will. More, it's like a little worse than 1/3 of any factor in rares. But I digress. But yeah, it's still a fun run. We get through it. Let's see what the others did. What did Mean do? Interesting, he settled for the aggressive at ring 4, but I guess it makes sense. He didn't have his Razor Sharp held over, which in some cases would be fine. Like, there's some... In some of those fights, this would have been better. He just gets faster scaling. And he essentially would have had an extra Razor Sharp worth of damage from the get-go, so I guess I can kind of see it. One thing here. I'm just curious why his multi-strike is in the middle and mine's not. Does that mean he found... You know, it must mean that he didn't take the ring for health. Or he just didn't, well, he didn't either didn't go to the Merchant of Steel on Ring 4, or he didn't buy the health. He had an Awoken Hollow infusion, that's interesting as well. Surprised he still took the Shroud Spike. How is he getting that off? He took a Space Prism, I guess, which opens that up. It's interesting because like he has to hit the Space Prism first and then do that. I mean, I guess it works though. And he also scales Primordium with his Awoken Hollow. I mean, that was definitely an option. I would have liked this probably more if I'd gone Stalwart. With Stalwart, then you get a lot of stats out of that, but it's tough at the same time. Like, these fights are sometimes just so fast that maybe the argument still, you know, by the time you hit the later stacks of Stalwart, the fight has already been kind of decided. Certainly in this one it did. It looks like he lost a lot there too. Not as bad as I did, but because he had the aggressive, so he would have had a little bit more extra damage. But yeah, same shit. It's like, damn. You get the fucking... I really do think that tank's a little overtuned. I mean, it's like 180 health? Okay. Literally, like... nothing in the game at that point remotely comes close to that amount of health. But pretty similar deck otherwise, right? Like, we added almost the same cards. There's a few differences here. Like, he took the Pyregro. He took Space Prism. He went a little more into the Void Binding here. I mean, that's fine. Especially since... I don't know if they ever fixed this bug. We don't know what his old magic is. It could be something completely different. It just always shows your old magic, I think. But yeah, I mean, it's pretty similar, right? Took the Petrified Heart. Makes sense. I mean, if you didn't take the Lifesteal and you don't care about the heals, I don't know though, is that making sense with the Awoken Hollow infusion? Because doesn't that mean it will not proc the Rejuvenates? I would have still rather just take Blood for Blood there instead of getting the health. I mean, Prismal Dust, Superfood, I don't think you need the health. Sap Tap, interesting. I don't even think we saw Sap Tap on ours. If we did... yeah, I don't think we did. So he definitely didn't go ring three where we where we went then, huh? Yeah, he must have gone somewhere different than we went ring three. I don't even know what we did. Oh yeah, we went hunting for magic stuff. Yeah, good run, Mean. That was good. Evil went with the Shattered Shell self-infuse. I mean, technically it's potentially better than what I did, but I still don't like the Shattered Shell infusion. I'm unconvinced that it's worth 25 shards, but it's not like a big mistake to take it. It's like a personal preference thing, I think. I think I'd almost just rather not go there. I do think my plus draw was relevant, though. Like, when I was drawing plus 10 at the end there, I was, like, always usually at a point that I would have been at plus 9 had I not had it. There's only a few that I went severely over. So he started Stalwart. That's interesting. And then he ends up with basically what I would have preferred to have, right? Like, this is actually... so if you start Stalwart, it looks like you end up getting... oh, no, you know what? You don't. I misread that. So he ends up getting a final point of aggressive. You'll notice his attack is at 10. So it looks like the Stalwart Superfood Dream just never came to fruition on this seed. Still, this seems like it'd be okay if you got the right cards, though. But he more or less didn't. Also, his Prismal Dusts would be a lot worse. I mean, they're still very powerful, right? They're double stacked. But, you know, since he doesn't have Superfood, they're not transferring the D. He never found Multi-Strike either. Which I would say is iffy. He still has Plinks in the deck, even some upgraded ones, so I don't think the Vortex was low value for him at that point. It's certainly not too bad to have not gone to that steal where we found multi-strike, because there was value on the other side, but I don't know. I think it's tough to say. You know, if you go there, you don't get multi-strike. You're just removing some plinks. I get it. I would have to, like, reconstruct the situation he was in at that point. See, I do kind of not like starting a stalwart here, though, for... You can just see how it kind of forced him into a little bit less powerful of a deck, right? Like, he has to take a mortal trade. Because for us, we know we're pretty much good with Prismal Dust. We have Superfood. But with him, he has to add a mortal trade. He even has to maybe... Well, I don't know why the Fine Grasp is in there. I probably wouldn't add that. But like the Glimmers actually have to have damage. I don't know. Especially with the Self-Infuse and the Shattered Shell, I'm not a huge fan of this, I guess. Like, that's 25 shards that you poured into that Glimmer. But you've also poured 25 shards in here, basically saying especially without the multi-strike, you kind of need those kills for your scaling. So this didn't make it to the boss. Let's see. So Ensnare wasn't found at this point, so no harm, no foul there, but... Remnant Pack. That could be okay on the Primordium. I don't know though. You can tell we just went really different paths on the board. I mean, he has no artifacts. He has no holdovers. We found a few. So it's like, it's not necessarily, I guess what I'm not saying it's wrong the way he did, but I will say is the ways he went were less fortunate, right? Because it just doesn't seem like he found much good upgrades, like double stack. We'd have probably much rather had found holdover. So he didn't take Making of a Morsel, which is interesting, which then also meant that he didn't take the Shroud Spike. I think I would have liked... I'm trying to remember. It was like Space Prism, Bottled Morsel, and Making of a Morsel. I think there's more upside. Space Prism, as good as it normally is, I don't think you gain much with Awoken, and especially with Primordium Awoken. Like, you're so likely to be just all inning on one unit that the Space Prism just isn't that useful. But the Making of a Morsel could be some extra scaling, but then it also opens up a card like Shroud Spike to be pretty good. It wasn't good in this run, but I still like just the thought process there of prioritizing Making of a Morsel over Space Prism. I think I like. Justin Brar. This is the original submitter, so same deal with the Shattered Shell. So he has a Superfood. See, I don't think I like the Immortal Trade take here, when you already have the Superfood and the Prismal Dusts. He took Mask. I don't like that over the Improved Firebox. Improved Firebox is like, when you're just starting Plinks, especially with Primordium, like, I definitely don't think I like Mask over what this is. I mean, think about how good Firebox was on this run. You already start with the Prismal Dusts too, and you had Superfood already. That just to me is Firebox all day, every day. Which would further make it so he didn't have to take a Mortal Trade. Every card you take is another potential bad draw. When, like, you're not looking for a Mortal Trade early, right? You're looking for your Razor Sheriff Edge, you're looking for Root Seeds even. This guy also did the glimmer. I don't know. It seems to me this just seems so at odds itself to do the shattered shell infusion while also spending 25 shards on the glimmer. I would, if anything, you had a mask of penumbra, put it into a plink, right? If that's the plan there, take a plink. Also didn't take the making of a morsel, thus making the shroud spike just kind of not takeable. But yeah, I think similar things though here, I think similar differences. You know, it's a tough one because it's like, I'm trying to think, like, had I not found multi-strike, do I make it through penitent? Because we wouldn't have had root split mask. We would have lost luggage. I would have a deck that's like, what, 20 size at that point. And it basically, you know, I'm cycling the whole deck every two turns. I would have still at least had the old magic. So I had a holdover. I didn't have a holdover old magic, but I'd have an old magic. I would have the holdover razor sharp edge. I'd have my shroud spike. You know, I basically have everything, but just imagine there's no multi-strike here, and I'd probably settle for like a plus 10, right? So plus 10 for what that's worth. I'd have the 10-10 there. I have to imagine I would definitely leak for sure, but I would have full health at that point, and I could replenish a bit of it through blood for blood and refracting lenses. I do feel I would make it through it, and then even without the multi-strike, I think once I find a root split mask along with the ensnare, I'm probably good. But certainly having a multi-strike helps. Be interesting thought experiment. I'm not dedicated enough to go through the entire thing again and just not take multi-strike there and see if it gets through, but I do think I get through there without it. But we're certainly happy to have it. I mean, that's kind of why we factor in, you know, even though it's a 50-50. But yeah, Justin didn't survive long enough to find it, and Eable just didn't go to the steel that had it. But yeah. It's tough, because some of these, it's like, is it just the unfortunate fact that they didn't find multi-strike that made them lose? It is kind of that powerful of an upgrade, right? I can't say for sure. But maybe my own hubris will say that I didn't need it. Anyway, though, probably droned on long enough about this one. I do thank everybody for watching, as always. And until next time, peace.